Facebook family. My name is Tiffany Falkenstein. I'm a senior admissions counselor here at Central Penn College. And if you look around behind me, what you're gonna see is what we call our super suites. You see, Central Penn is very diverse, not only in the kind of people that you're gonna find here, but in the way we run our business. We don't have dormitories at our school. Instead, what you're gonna find as an incoming freshman is the super suites. There are 7 bedrooms and 1 housing unit, 3 bathrooms that you share. Everyone gets their own bedroom. That is definitely an advantage. I brought some tips with me today that I thought might help you if you're an incoming freshman coming into college, some things that might be beneficial. Tip number 1 would be request to live with friends. You see, it's a lot easier to be a roommate with someone that you already know. And then if there's an issue or a problem, it's also easier to address that issue with someone that you know. But I will tell you, just a little cautiously, that you really don't know someone until you live with them. Tip number 2, address problems early. You see, any problem that's small now, well, every time she takes a shower, she leaves her hair in the shower. Or she never cleans up after she's in the bathroom. It's a mess all the time. Well, those little things turn into big things and start to annoy you pretty quickly if, in fact, you don't take care of them right away. Tip number 3 is respect your roommate's stuff. Okay, so true story time. My freshman year in college, I had a roommate that didn't like mornings. I'm a morning person, up and out, nice and early, and I would tell you probably 4 days out of 5 when she was off to her classes, she would be wearing my clothes, even things that still had tags on. For some reason, she thought it was appropriate to take my clothing. So after year number 1, I decided to request another roommate. Year number 2, my roommate didn't take my clothes. Instead, she would always steal the food that I brought home from my parents' house when I went home for a weekend visit. Just in case you're wondering, that is inappropriate roommate behavior. Now, respect number 4 is be mindful of who you're bringing into your room, your space, and exactly what time. You see, if you're doing an evening study session with your friends, it can get a little bit loud, and that's fine unless I have a 7:30 a.m. test or a 7:30 a.m. class. Then I'm not so happy with you being my roommate, bringing your friends in here and making lots of noise. Please be respectful. And my last tip is probably the best one. Coming from a mother, treat others the way that you would like to be treated. Now, shall we take a little tour of our space? Dining area. This is a shared area that you would share with all of your friends and all of your roommates. Comes with a nice little refrigerator over there in the corner. And if you come back this way, the shower and the toilet are separate from the sink area. That's nice because you have an opportunity to brush your teeth while someone else is taking a shower. And then, as I said, everyone gets their own room. This is incredible. An opportunity to lock the door when you leave so your roommate isn't wearing your clothes. Hey, if you're interested in Central Penn, you can give me a call. My number is area code 717-728-2312. Or you can jump online at centralpenn@admissions.edu. Thanks.